Principles of Real Estate Practice, 6th Edition. Written by Stephen Mettling and David Cusic. Narrated by Julian Kasow.
Chapter 1. The Real Estate Business. In its broadest sense, the real estate industry is the largest single industry in the American economy. Within it, one might include the construction industry, itself often considered our country's largest business. In addition, the real estate industry may be said to include the creation, management, and demolition of every residence and business facility in the nation: offices, warehouses, factories, stores, and special purpose buildings such as hospitals and government facilities. The real estate business would include as well the managing of all the undeveloped land in the country, national parks, forests, and the vast quantity of unused federal property. Real estate professionals are individuals and business organizations whose sole enterprise is performing a real estate-related service or function. A wide range of professions is available to persons wishing to enter the real estate business. Real estate professionals perform the following property-related functions: creation and improvement, management and maintenance, demolition, investment ownership, regulation, and transfer. Creation and improvement. Creating real properties from raw land involves capital formation, financing, construction contracting, and regulatory approvals. The key parties involved in this aspect of the business are generally the developer, the landowner, and the mortgage lender. Also involved are market analysts, architects, engineers, space planners, interior designers, and construction subcontractors. Experts who manage the legal aspects of the development project include real estate attorneys, title companies, surveyors, property insurance companies, and government regulatory officials. The brokerage community, with the assistance of professional appraisers, usually handles the ownership and leasing transactions that occur over the many phases of development. Management and maintenance. All real estate, whether raw land or improved property, must be managed and maintained. The two principal types of managers are property managers and asset managers. Property managers and their staff oversee specific properties on behalf of the owners, making sure the condition of the property and its financial performance meet specific standards. Asset managers oversee groups of properties or portfolios. Their role is to achieve the investment objectives of the owners as opposed to managing day-to-day operations. Maintenance personnel include engineers, systems technicians, janitorial staff, and other employees needed to maintain the property's condition. Demolition. Demolition experts, in conjunction with excavation and debris removal experts, serve to remove properties that are no longer economically viable from the market. Investment ownership. A specialized niche in the real estate business is the real estate investor who risks capital in order to buy, hold, and sell real properties. In contrast to property owners whose primary interest is in some other business, the real estate investor focuses on identifying and exploiting real estate investment opportunities for profit. The real estate investor provides capital and liquidity to the real estate market. Regulation. All real estate is to some degree regulated by the government. The principal areas of regulation are usage, taxation, and housing administration. Professional regulatory functions include public planners, zoning administrators, building inspectors, assessors, and administrators of specific federal statutes, such as federal fair housing laws. Transfer. Rights and interests in real estate can be bought, sold, assigned, leased, exchanged, inherited, or otherwise transferred from one owner to another. Real estate brokers and the broker's salespeople are generally centrally involved in such transfers. Other professional participants are mortgage brokers, mortgage bankers, appraisers, insurers, and title companies. Property type specialization. In addition to specializing by function, many professionals also specialize in the type of property they work with. According to the purpose of ownership, properties are classified as residential, commercial, or investment properties. Residential property refers to property that is owned and used for habitation. Such properties may be further classified in terms of how many families they are designed to house, whether they are attached to other units or detached, and so forth. Commercial property generally refers to retail and office properties, but may also include industrial real estate. The term commercial relates to the fact that the property can potentially generate income from a business's usage. Investment property refers to any property that is held by its owners for investment purposes. All classifications of property may be investment properties. Generally, however, the term does not refer to owner-occupied residences, even though such properties constitute an investment. Apartments, condominiums, cooperatives, and single-family homes may be considered as investment property if non-occupants own the property for investment purposes. These properties are also referred to as residential income properties. According to use, the following classifications of real properties are commonly accepted. These categories are not absolute, since properties often have overlapping uses. A bank, for example, may have retail as well as office operations. An industrial distribution facility may include extensive office space. A retail center may contain offices. Special purpose properties include publicly or privately owned recreational facilities, government buildings, churches and schools, and so on. Real estate brokerage. Most newly licensed practitioners choose to begin their real estate careers in residential brokerage. Primary real estate brokerage activities involve performance of one or more of the following tasks: locating a buyer for a seller, locating a seller for a buyer, locating a tenant for a landlord, or locating a landlord for a tenant. A seller, buyer, landlord, or tenant hires a broker to procure the opposite party to the sale or lease transaction. To help get the job done, the broker hires licensed agents as assistants. The brokerage company, in its simplest form, consists of a broker and the broker's agents, who work together to locate buyers, sellers, tenants, and landlords for the broker's clients. Forms of specialization. In the modern brokerage environment, brokers and agents specialize along the following lines: property type, geographical area, type of transaction, type of client, or type of relationship. One's choice of specialization is influenced by competitive factors in the market and by perceived opportunities. Property type. Since different properties have different features and potential buyers, brokers commonly choose to specialize in a property type. Thus, there are residential agents, commercial agents, industrial agents, and land agents. Geographical area. Brokers and agents must maintain current, accurate data on properties. It is not possible to keep track of every property in larger markets. Therefore, one must create an area of geographical specialization. One's area may be defined by natural barriers, by streets and highways, or by a certain set of subdivisions. Type of transaction. The principal types of transaction are sales, leases and subleases, exchanges, and options. Each form of transaction involves particular legal documents and considerations. As a result, many agents, particularly commercial agents, specialize in a type of transaction. For example, in an urban commercial property market, agents generally specialize in either leases or sales. Type of client. Brokers increasingly represent buyers and tenants as well as sellers and landlords. Since conflicts of interest may be involved, many brokers restrict their business to representing either buyers and tenants or sellers and landlords exclusively. Some brokers and agents also specialize according to the type of business their clients are in or their motivations for the transaction. Thus, one finds brokers who focus exclusively on hospitals or fast food chains or executive relocations. Type of relationship. In recent years, many brokers have specialized in providing advisory services to clients instead of the traditional transaction-based commission-compensated services. In the advisory relationship, the broker works on identified real estate tasks or projects in exchange for a fee, salary, or retainer. The fee advisor may or may not focus on completing a transaction. Some of the individual brokerage services that one might perform for a preset fee are comparative price analysis, database search, prospect screening, and site analysis.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.